So here we will prove the property of gamma function, and for that I have a question for you. That is, gamma 3 by 2 minus x into gamma 3 by 2 plus x is equal to 1 by 4 minus x square whole into pi sec pi x. Now the question is how to prove this. So if you see the left hand side, we have two gamma functions, and for the gamma functions we have n number of properties, so we can apply the property to get the right hand side. So let's start with the left hand side. So here I'll say the LHS is equal to gamma 3 upon 2 minus x into gamma 3 upon 2 plus x. Now since on the right hand side we want 1 upon 4 minus x square, we cannot continue with the 3 by 2 term, so we have to reduce this 3 by 2 term into 1 by 2, so that 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 can become 1 upon 4. And for that here I will use the property of gamma function. So we have a property like this, that is gamma n is equal to n minus 1 gamma n minus 1. So guys, by applying this property over here, we will get 3 by 2 minus x will behave as n, and then we'll do minus 1. So that will become 1 by 2 minus x gamma 1 by 2 minus x. Similarly, by applying this property for the second term, we will get 1 upon 2 plus x into gamma 1 upon 2 plus x. Now the terms which are outside the gamma function, if we multiply these terms, then we will get 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, that is 1 upon 4, and this will become minus x square. So here we got this term, and the remaining two gamma functions are 1 by 2 minus x into 1 by 2 plus x. Now the question arises, how to prove that these two gamma functions are equivalent to pi into sec pi x. So guys, whenever I see pi, it reminds me about the formula of either gamma 1 upon 2, because the value of gamma 1 by 2 is root pi, or it reminds me about one of the property of gamma function, which is like this: gamma p gamma 1 minus p is equal to pi by sine of p pi. So guys, you can see here that here we have pi in the numerator. Now we just have to check whether this two gamma function have the values as p and 1 minus p or not. So let's assume that the value of p is 1 by 2 plus x. So if p is 1 by 2 plus x, 1 minus p, that is 1 minus 1 by 2 plus x, will give us 1 by 2 minus x. So yes, it is exactly matching with gamma p into gamma 1 minus p. So we can definitely use this property. So here I'll say it is equal to 1 by 4 minus x square, and we have considered p as 1 by 2 plus x, so this will become pi upon sine of 1 by 2 plus x into pi. Now let's evaluate this. So when pi will come inside, that will become pi by 2 plus pi x, and we know that sine of pi by 2 plus theta is cos theta, so that will become cos pi x. So here I can say it is 1 by 4 minus x square into pi by cos of pi x. And guys, now it's just a single step that we have to take that cos in the numerator, so 1 by cos will become sec, so we will get the value as pi into sec pi x. So we have reached the value and we have reached the answer. So here we have completed this problem by using the properties of gamma function, and I'm very sure that you like this video. And if you want to learn the more concepts of engineering mathematics and beta and gamma function, then do not forget to log into ekera.com today itself to get all the videos, all the concepts at the one place. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter anytime by logging to Facebook or Twitter and searching Professor Maheshwar. Thank you very much.